Hello students, Apna Study presents you the Hindu News Bulletins for the 12th of July. Before we start, don't forget to like, share and subscribe.
National News. COVID-19 vaccination, the Ministry of Railways.
Ministry of Railways has called for full preparedness to ensure testing, tracking and treating of patients. Railways will enforce COVID appropriate behavior and also vaccinate all employees, beneficiaries in its premises. Most vulnerable group could be unvaccinated individuals, particularly those below the age of 18.
Jammu bombings, a first of its kind attack in India.
The pressure fuse used is similar to the ones used by the Pakistani army. The pressure fuse is generally used in minefields, anti-tank mines and those dropped by the air force in the fuselage between the explosive and main detonator of a shell or an IED.
COVID-19, the effects of weather on symptoms.
The lingering second COVID-19 wave and the current weather have prompted doctors to caution the general public to strictly follow COVID appropriate behavior. The effect of worsened weather on an ongoing illness contributed in terms of aggravated symptoms, said Anurag Agarwal, Associate Consultant, Internal Medicine, Faridabad.
Rath Yatra in Puri, Orissa.
The world-famous Rath Yatra was being conducted without devotees in view of the prevailing COVID-19 pandemic. The police blocked every lane and by-lane leading to the venue in Puri from Sunday to Tuesday. People have been advised to stock up on essential goods as all shops will remain closed till Tuesday.
India evacuates personnel from Consulate General in Kandahar.
India has evacuated personnel from the Consulate General in Kandahar as a temporary measure in view of the fighting between the Taliban and Afghan security forces. Official spokesperson Arindam Bagchi said the mission is not closed and the visa-related work has been shifted to the Indian Embassy in Kabul.
Hindustan Aeronautics Limited to deliver light combat helicopters to the Indian Air Force.
HAL is gearing up to deliver the first batch of 3 light combat helicopters to the Indian Air Force. These are part of the 15 limited series production, LSP, helicopters approved for the Army and the IAF. The deal for the 15 LSP helicopters was expected to have been signed in the first quarter of 2021 but has been delayed due to the second wave of the pandemic.
New IT rules ensure safer and more responsible social media ecosystem.
The new IT rules will ensure a safer and more responsible social media ecosystem in India, the minister said. The new rules, which came into effect from May 25, mandate social media companies to establish a grievance redress mechanism for resolving complaints from the users or victims. Facebook-owned WhatsApp has challenged the new rules for social media intermediaries.
International news. Two lawsuits pitting Saudi Arabia's de facto ruler against a former intelligence czar threatened to expose sensitive US government secrets.
Cases center on corruption allegations leveled by state-owned Saudi companies against Saad Aljabri. Mr. Aljabria worked closely with US officials on covert counterterrorism operations. His patron, Prince Mohammed bin Nayef, is currently in Saudi detention after being deposed in 2017.
North Korea and China to strengthen relations.
North Korean leader Kim Jong-un says it is the fixed stand of his government to ceaselessly develop the friendly and cooperative relations. Under the 1961 Treaty of Friendship, Cooperation and Mutual Assistance, North Korea and China are committed to offering one another immediate military and other aid in the event of an attack. North Korea has been expected to seek greater support from China, its major ally and aid benefactor.
Virgin Galactic founder Richard Branson beats Jeff Bezos.
Richard Branson and 5 crewmates reach an altitude of 88 kilometers over the New Mexico desert. Mr. Branson became the first person to blast off in his own spaceship, beating Mr. Bezos by 9 days. He also became only the second septuagenarian to depart for space.
Haitian President Jovenel Moïse gives first statement since assassination.
Martine Moïse issued the recorded statement in Creole from the Miami hospital where she was being treated for wounds suffered in the attack early on Wednesday. "I'm alive, thanks to God, but I love my husband Jovenel. We fought together for more than 25 years," she said in the recording.
Afghanistan air defense system at Kabul airport to counter incoming rockets.
Afghan authorities install anti-missile system at Kabul airport to counter incoming rockets. Officials did not offer details about the type of system or who had installed it. The Taliban have regularly launched rockets and mortars at government forces across the countryside. The Islamic fundamentalist group's rapid gains in recent weeks have raised fears about the security of the capital.
Business news. Transfer your vehicle insurance to the buyer, get your no-claim bonus.
No-claim bonus, NCB, is the accumulated reward for your claim-free record. This can go up to 40% and you get to encash it at renewal as a discount. When you sell your car, the NCB stays with you as it is attached to you, not the vehicle.
Sports news. Lavalleni's ankle is twisted.
French pole vaulter Renaud Lavalleni twisted his ankle during a competition in northern France on Sunday. The 34-year-old landed awkwardly on the mat and immediately pulled out of the Sautwil-lès-Rouen meet. The 2012 Olympic champion is one of the main medal hopes of France's track and field team. He is ranked second in the world with 5.92 meters behind Swedish world record holder Amo Duplantis.
Neeraj Chopra, the brightest prospect to win an independent India Olympic medal.
Neeraj Chopra is the brightest prospect to win independent India's first ever athletics medal at the Olympics. The 23-year-old is currently number 4 in the world list this year. Chopra finished third with 86.79 meters and which Johannes Wetter won with 93.59 meters.